as Aldridge down the floor, cross mat situation. Giannis took advantage of it, using his speed.
Much trap, DeJounte Murray. He nearly threw it away. Aldridge with less than 10 on the shot clock.
And that foot injury of Giannis has looked okay right there.
Patty Mills, right in front of his offseason trainer who used to work for the Bucks.
That situation on numerous occasions on the sideline out of bounds, Spurs weren't going for it. That's what I'm talking about, being well scouted and executing the game plan.
Bledsoe picks up his first, the offensive foul. It's Milwaukee's third turnover. Aldridge turns and hits over John Henson.
Well, dude, the Spurs are the gold standard, kind of bringing it out of you. You know you're going to have to bring your best to compete with them this afternoon.
And that's why the playoffs should bring out the best in the Bucks as well.
Yeah, I think it will. It's just playing off the intensity that's in the building right now. Look at that. That Dirk Nowitzki. Pulling that Dirk Nowitzki from the elbow.
Very productive spot for threes, typically. Green leaves it for Aldridge, left-hander off the glass. Timeout, Milwaukee. The point is, a lot of teams bring the ball.
All right, once again, you can catch that story after tonight's NCAA game. 60 minutes, Giannis Antetokounmpo being featured, Jim.
Yeah, how about the leading audience, Duke in Kansas? Scheduled for six. Mike can push back a little if the game runs long, but tune in and watch Giannis. A three. Milwaukee 21st in three-point percentage, 35.6. San Antonio is a little lower than that. Aldridge in the paint.
Well, listen, I don't know how much longer you can. Now you just got one guy isolated against two defenders shooting jump shots. You're playing right into the hands of the Spurs.
I can't remember the last time I heard the term zone offense.
Yep.
Rim offense, yes, LaMarcus Aldridge.
And like you mentioned, Utah, those two teams do a great job of taking away the money ball, the sweet areas in this league, corner threes.
And typically they slow it down and take away possessions,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, points at the rim.
Ginobili. Aldridge. Take on Toronto, or do they want to move up to seventh and get Boston with potentially no Kyrie Irving in the first round, or at least for a part of the first round?
Well, yeah, I think Boston, and for a couple of reasons, no Kyrie Irving, but also means you're playing some pretty good basketball if you're winning games down the stretch. But
9.5 to play in the third quarter.
So I was wondering who match up against Tony Parker. It's going to be Chris Middleton. Not a bad matchup for him. Played a lot of two guard in his career.
LaMarcus Aldridge, a little fadeaway.
Call the Wetzel LaMarcus Aldridge right here, just ISO'd up top at the elbow, peeks at the shot clock, sees Giannis in the area.
In the quarter, 3.5 minutes gone so far in this period. Ginobili. That's a pretty good look and pass for LaMarcus Aldridge. And scored off of that. They find an open shooter, John Henson. Kyle Anderson pulls in the rebound. Under 7.5 to play in the fourth.
I mean, percentage-wise, that's the guy you want taking that shot. And that's the guy you want in their high-low offense. They go high-low if you're the Spurs and you get Pau Gasol on the floor along with LaMarcus Aldridge. Tony, it'd be great if Tony Snell could deny that pass.
Henson has Aldridge. Snell trying to help.
Nice move.
Yeah.
You're up and under, but I mean, you got Pau Gasol on the floor. You know they're going high low. If you can stop the catch from Gasol, you can stop the pass into Aldridge. Yeah, geez,
that was smooth.
I paid too much for this turn.
5:05 left, fourth quarter. LaMarcus Aldridge.
Every time.
Drops the shoulder.
Every time. I mean, at what point do you double team?